skin dryness can become problematic for patients with Sjogren syndrome, as it may lead to itchiness and rashes. In my previous videos, I have discussed about a lot of tips that you can use to manage the dryness of the eyes, dryness of the mouth, and vaginal dryness. In today's video, I will discuss how to manage dryness of your skin. Why? Because maintaining a healthy skin is very important, as your skin is the barrier of your body that protects you from the environment. A dry skin can cause irritation, itching, increased risk for skin infection, and premature aging.
Rheumatologistoncall.com.
Here are 8 tips that you can use if you suffer from dry skin. Number 1. Start using unscented skin moisturizer daily. Moisturizers that contain glycerin, lanolin, and topical urea immediately after you take a bath seems to be very helpful in patients with Sjogren. The key is to look for products that are unscented and contain less chemicals. The shorter the list of ingredients, the better will be for you. Number 2. Instead of using a lot of moisturizer cream, you can apply a more greasier cream because they will reduce the water loss from your skin. Now, many females do not enjoy a greasy cream. Now, I get you, but consider to apply them at least at nighttime. Number 3. Avoid excessive washing, for example, multiple times a day. Excessive washing may worsen your dry skin, particularly when you use hot water. So I do recommend you to use just warm water if you take a shower every day. And definitely avoid hot showers. Number 4. You should avoid aggressive scrubbing of your skin. Use a soft cotton towel and slowly tap your skin after a bath without aggressive scrubbing. Number 5. Use a humidifier, especially during winter time and colder months. Like I said in my previous videos about treating the dry mouth and dry eyes, consider to buy and start using a humidifier in the room. If you put an ultrasonic humidifier in the room, that will help you. I will put a link in the description to a humidifier that I use in my house. There are many humidifiers that you can buy, but consider to buy one that is ultrasonic, because that one will break the water into small particles that can get deeper and deeper into your airways and also into your skin. Number 6. Use mild cleansers, because traditional soaps will cause alkalinization of the skin and can also cause damage of the natural skin moisture barrier. And in this way, they can worsen the dryness and can cause more itchiness. Now, synthetic detergents, cleansers like Aveeno Moisturizing Bar or Cetaphil Gentle or Cleansing Bar or Dove Sensitive Skin or Unscented Beauty Bar, those are preferable, or lipid-free cleansers. Those are better for your skin. I will leave a link to all of these products to be easier for you to find them. Number 7. Avoid all fragranced moisturizers and heavily fragranced cleansers. Number 8. Continue to use sunblock sunscreen with a higher SPF. And also use sun protective clothing, because that will protect your skin from further dryness caused by sun exposure. Now I would like you to leave me a comment in the bottom of this video and tell me what products did you try, which one was helpful for you, as we all need to learn and we should share our knowledge. If you experience dryness in the mouth, eyes, or vaginal dryness, don't forget to watch my other videos in this channel. I share there a lot of the tips that you can use to manage your symptoms and feel better. And if you want to learn more, don't forget to give a like, share, and subscribe to my channel to support my educational videos. And don't forget that these videos are just for educational purposes and will not substitute medical advice, diagnosis, or treatment. You should always talk to your physician and address your specific concerns. Thank you and have a wonderful day.
Rheumatologist OnCall.com